support. So thank you very much. Welcome, Chip Leer.
You gotta think about it a little bit. And when we finally get there, we're going to try to put everything together of how we're going to connect with those fish. I can't get over how far we've come in this sport. This is mind-boggling. There was a time where all you had to do was go out into the retail store and you could buy the best of everything. It wasn't all that much money, but there were so few choices. Now, there's a lot of choices, and there's a lot of really good equipment, from augers to houses to electronics. I mean, there's a lot of really good choices. The more specialized or the more you can narrow down what you need, the better off you're going to be. In fact, for me, I'm a sworn tackle junkie. I have a lot of gear. I've been in this store, I've been in retail stores every week, all year long, love being at bait shops, got here this morning, found something I like, they got it behind the counter so I can buy it before I'm leaving, I'm not lying, I got a problem, okay? But I'm here to work through this thing together. And where I'm going with all this is there's so much tackle, we're going to go down to talk about refining it in a little bit. But the more you can narrow down that tackle or those choices, the better off you are. Especially when it comes to being able to balance rods, reels, and gear for the size of the fish, that you're chasing. And it's more to do with the fact of the type of lure that you're using than the species that you're using. When you think about rods and reels and gear, it's more about what you're presenting, what's on the end of your line versus what we hook. We all get wrapped up in how big, we want a rod that's going to be able to fight the fish, and it needs to be able to do that too. But the key, the biggest key, and we're going to come spend some time on this in a minute, is whatever we got to do to tease the fish into actually biting. So it's about lure presentation and having the right size, the rod that matched with the reel, which matched with the fishing line, that's got the right size weight on the end of it, so that it presents that lure exactly like the way you want that lure present. That is, without a doubt, the most important part of the whole scenario here. With that, we're seeing a big resurgence, we're seeing a big surge into these type of reels here, these straight line type of reels. Has anybody used any of these right here? Anything like this? It's kind of started years ago, I don't even have a spinning reel here anymore, but years ago when we fished, you saw a lot of people holding rods like that. They were, just like you would hold your summer, basically just the same as you hold your summer fishing spinning reel. You're going to hold it just like this, and we lift and drop as we jig. Maybe you pop your rod tip, but whether you use it as an access point or your whole rod, it sits like that. And that works. It works in the summer. We get a bite, we set the hook, crank it in, all works fine and dandy. And ice fishing, especially since we're a lot of times in small portable houses, it became apparent that if we're stationary and we're sitting somewhere, like so, I'm gonna grab this one here. We're sitting here and we start fishing, instead of holding the rod like this, lift, drop, if we hold the rod like this and put our finger on it, we can actually get micro movements. A couple things happen here. One, we can get smaller, more micro movements out of your jig. If you fish for bluegills and you've ever watched on a camera, there a lot of times it isn't how big you move it, it's how subtle you move it. And you need movement. It's gotta move. You've gotta have some of that plastic or whatever bit you have on there. It's gotta undulate a little bit. But you need it to move real small. So if you hold it more like this, what we call a pistol grip, and put your finger on the rod, you can actually just kind of bounce your fingertip on that rod and get that rod tip to undulate also just a little bit, just by barely touching it and just getting a little bit of a feather movement on it, or even just brushing the side of it. And most importantly, from a fishing standpoint, when you, if you're fishing it like this, I don't know if you've ever been there, but you can tell if the person next to you is using a spinning rod and catching fish, because as you go to set the hook like this, it takes a lot of movement to get to here, where I can start to drive the hook into the fish's mouth, right? If I put it in a pistol grip like this, and I'm holding it, and I want to set the hook, it's the flip of a wrist. That far versus that far. So I want to get the hook in the fish, less movement, quicker hook set. Most importantly, if you're fishing a flip over portable, then you're fishing a fish, you know how you know if the guy's catching it next to you? You hear that flop, flop on the top of the fish house, boom, boom. See? Stealthy. Part of this whole deal, and the reason you're not going to leave, you don't want to leave before this is over, is two reasons. One is the food. You know they're not serving until we're done. Two is, I'm gonna give you a little secret at the end that will help you outfish everybody you work with and everybody your buddies. There's one little tip at the end. You gotta stick around with that. It's a little tease, okay? Don't go too far. But that, how you hold that rod makes a big difference with that.